So let us see what Fermat's theorem is. Fermat's theorem, also known as Fermat's little theorem. It states that if P is a prime number and A is any positive integer which is not divisible by P, then in that case A power P minus 1 is congruent to 1 mod P. Right? So P is a prime number and A is any number which is not divisible by P, then this relation is true. Let's take an example. So let A be equal to 7 and let P be equal to 19. So we will not be going through the proof. We will just see whether the Fermat's theorem is valid for P equal to 19 and A equal to 7. Right? So according to Fermat's theorem, 7 power 19 minus 1, which is 7 power 18, must be congruent to 1 mod 19. Right? So 7 power 18 must be congruent to 1 mod 19. So let's try to find out 7 power 18 and mod 19. So let's square 7. 7 square is nothing but 49. So in mod 19. So 7 square is 49 mod 19, which is nothing but 11 mod 19. Okay, so we need to find 7 power 18. So let me start by squaring 7. Okay, so now 7 power 4 is nothing but 11 square in mod 19. So I find that 11 square in mod 19 is 7 mod 19 itself. Right? So we get 121 mod 19. So we need to find the remainder, which gives 7. So again, let me square this. So 7 power 8 in mod 19 is nothing but 7 square mod 19. So we know that 7 square mod 19 is nothing but 11 mod 19. Okay? So again, 7 power 16, I square this. So is 11 square mod 19, which is nothing but 7 mod 19. So it so happens that the numbers go on repeating, isn't it? So 7 square, I get 11. Then I square this, you get 7. Then again, I square this, I get 11. So 11, 7, 11, 7, they go on repeating again and again as we square the terms. So what is 7 power 18? 7 power 18 can be written as 7 power 16 into 7 square. Right? So what is 7 power 16? 7 power 16 is 7 in mod 19. And 7 square is 11. So we get 77 mod 19. So 77 mod 19 is nothing but 1. Right? So therefore 7 power 18 is congruent to 1 mod 19 as per Fermat's theorem. So Fermat's theorem can be used to solve problems. So let's take a simple problem and see how we can apply Fermat's theorem to solve. So the question is, find 3 power 201 mod 11. Okay, so this is a very huge number, 3 power 201 and mod 11. And if I don't know Fermat's theorem, then I will have many steps. And finally, I'll have to calculate 3 power 201. But if I do remember Fermat's theorem, I can very easily calculate the value of 3 power 201 in mod 11. So what does Fermat's theorem state? So I have a number A, okay, which is 3 power P minus 1. So 11 is a prime number. 11 minus 1 is 10, is congruent to 1 mod 11. Right? So 3 power 10 is congruent to 1 mod 11. I need 3 power 201. So let me take 3 power 10 whole power 20, which is nothing but 1 power 20 mod 11. So this is 3 power 10 into 20, which gives me 3 power 200, which is congruent to 1 mod 11, right? So 3 power 10 into 20 is this. So 3 power 200 is 1 mod 11, because 1 power anything is 1. What do we need? We need 3 power 2 not 1. So I multiply this by 3. 3 into 1 mod 11. So this is 3 power 2 not 1, which gives me 3 mod 11. So very easily I can find the value, which is 3. Right? So 3 power 2 not 1 and mod 11 is 3. The answer is 3. So if we know Fermat's theorem, we can very easily calculate the answer for such problems. But if the value n is a prime number and a is any other number which is not divisible by p, right?